Hi, I'm Charlene Bauer, and here is our Ladies Co-Driver Challenge story, where Kristen was chosen to be my co-driver on this incredibly challenging three-day first-year event called the BF Goodrich Tires 36 Hours of Uwharrie. The stage is set as I wrap up the trail emissions experience by returning the Jeep Frankie back to Impulse Off-Road in Salt Lake City and pick up Ruby to head across country. Stopping a few times to visit some friends, but really throwing the miles down so I could pick up Kristen in Ohio at our first meet and greet.
Charlene picked me up in Cincinnati on Monday night, and we didn't get back to my house until late, so we only got a few hours of sleep Monday night. And you know how it is when you're getting ready to do something exciting. You can't sleep that well. So Monday night I didn't really sleep that well. And since then, it was go, go, go. We had stuff to do, things to manage. We had meet and greets that we had to take care of. We just had stuff that needed to be done. So we didn't get a lot of sleep even before the event started.
We jumped in the Jeep early on Tuesday morning and went to North Carolina, where we visited fellow BF Goodrich Tires performance team member Kyle Tucker, then followed it up with a local club dinner. Wednesday was a built-in day to get everything we needed organized, so we both knew where all of our tools, recovery items, and of course snacks were in the Jeep. Ruby needed a little extra love after the 2,000 plus mile drive, but she was fine. The guys at Extreme Machines got her going. We got all the goodies we needed, and we were off to enjoy new friends at our next meet and greet. Some locals and other competitors showed up. Be sure to check out our Facebook Live coverage of the event. Even though we were into the evening, we were still in full swing with our last real meal, our second Walmart trip for necessities, and all the little things that you have to do in a hotel room when you're on the road. We woke up early on Thursday and headed out to the Uwharrie Off-Road Training Center to commit ourselves to this wild event.
36 Hours of Uwharrie is essentially like a triathlon for people who do off-road events. I wouldn't say events, but like wheelers. It includes high lift jacking, it includes winching, it includes canoeing, not just canoeing, but basically managing your canoe, getting it on and off of your vehicle, transporting it to and from the water. It also includes a lot of activities that involve your spare tire, and it also involves navigating. You get a waypoint and you have to get there. And it's not just Siri or Google telling you how to get there. You have to find it once it's off the road. So you have to look at your map, you have to follow your trails, you have to trace every one of your steps, because even on the way back, you still have to find your way back. It's not just getting there, it's getting back from where you came from. So it's everything from start to finish. Camping, wheeling, and all of the activities to and from wheeling. So it's basically a triathlon for off-road events.
Ready?
I'm very ready.
Here we go, right?
Go.
Time.
We're committing ourselves
to 36 hours of Uwharrie. Really did feel like that too with the military theme. Once we came in, we couldn't go back out. But first, we got our only canoe lesson with who affectionately became Cammy the Canoe.
Now if you feel it rocking, see how you're just swiveling at your hips and you're staying still with your upper body?
Yeah.
That's how you stay in a canoe. If you try to make a move with the canoe, then she's going to try to counter, and then you guys are going to get that whip, and then over you go.
So we made a couple of adjustments and added our mark to the store. We started to meet some of the great volunteer staff that would cheer us on for the entire rest of the weekend.
We commend you for accepting this challenge. This our first, you are our charter class. We will make this event great together.
That was Scott Fields, the mind behind this event. The BF Goodrich Tires 36 Hours of Uwharrie was built with Camel Trophy elements in mind. With the help from the Path Less Traveled and the International 4-Wheel Drive Trainers Association groups, they created a three-day format that pushed all the competitors to different degrees. But first, they fed us one last dinner. So you're probably wondering where we're going because our camp and everything is right behind us. Well, let us show you. Yeah.
The porta potties are all the way over here. Check out that distance. Awesome.
Once the event started, we didn't get much sleep either. We took advantage of every minute that they had given us. We made sure that we did everything we could possibly do, and we pushed ourselves and we tried really hard, which meant we had to choose between resting and getting points, and we opted to get points, which I'm really glad that we did. I mean, I wholeheartedly believe that was the right decision, but we didn't get much sleep.
Set them boys how it's done. 3 minutes, 20 seconds right now, girls. Yep, 3.5 minutes. Y'all are doing great. Don't give up. Y'all got this. Come on now. Go, girl, go!
So those were the first two events we chose to start the day. We instantly got red mud everywhere and missed the target, but that didn't matter. We had a lot more to do.
Okay, so we had to do a spare tire change, which, long story short, the mission was to take the front passenger side tire off.
Yep.
One of us had to run it around this little couch that we have out here.
Which was you, so show us we're talking about it.
Roll it. My goal for this is just to take the smallest circle, hug the line.
Oh, this was the house.
Steady. Yeah, so slow and steady.
What did he say?
1930? 30? I think he said.
Or 13s. This looks like a 13s.
Yeah.
Look at that rock. That's cool.
It's cool. You did it without all the heavy machines that we've now.
So, you rolled the tire?
Yeah, I rolled. Look at this little car.
Look at that.
With
car.
Bullet holes in it. So, roll it.
Sorry about our heavy breathing and sweat movements. It's pretty gross.
But it's real.
Super real.
So I rolled the tire around the house, around to the back of the Jeep. Charlene took the spare out of the back of the Jeep and threw it onto the front passenger side.
Yep.
I came back and worked on some lug nuts. Carlene threw the spare tire in the back. She came back and got stuff tightened up. I got all of the little stuff packed back away. We had a minute to readjust the canoe. We made it in. Little hiccups, but we did great.
Look, check her out.
Not really sure what happened.
So we were dirty within the first 20 minutes today.
Not even 20 minutes. I'd
here,
give it like
around,
12.
We?
And then Charlie. Give me a once over. Spin.
Blind right here.
Yeah.
So
look at our boots. Look at our fancy new boots.
Look. They're not clean anymore.
Nope. No returning these. I feel like that I owned the part that we had to just sit down and figure things out. We did get frustrated at times, but we also were able to step back, kind of reassess the situation.
Okay, we are going to straighten up your tire, and when you feel your ass end bump, you're going to hit it hard passenger. Are you hard. Recording that?
The most challenging missions for me were the ones that were involving the canoe. It was heavy, it was really awkward to carry. There's an obvious height difference between Charlene and I, so that kind of added an additional challenge for us. I had to convince myself that I was big enough and I was strong enough to do it, that I was useful. We did it, and we owned it.
All right, ladies, HPT to the pile there. Boat out of the water and report to me to time back in.
We both pushed hard on the first day, doing things we had never done before, including Kristen rigging this triple winch. As we came in for the night to get dinner, we were asked by the commandant to finish a couple of the challenges next to camp. In a minute, you'll see my most challenging feat, almost 2 hours of high lift jack winching while our fellow competitors were in camp. As the time went on, the crowd grew to include most all the judges, cheering us on. I never gave up, I re-rigged and pulled, and finally got Ruby across the line.
Two, three, four, five, come on, six, seven,
come on,
eight,
come on, one more,
that's it, you got it, woo,
woo,
got it.
Go, Charlene! Yeah!
Holy cow, we did it! 20 minutes later, we slammed some peanut butter and jelly sandwiches and went out on our night missions, keeping with my motto that we always have to at least try.
We keep having to check out the window to make sure the commandant isn't marching through.
I know, I hear some spraying. It might be foot spray. I doubt it's bug spray.
It's probably foot spray. Or probably the 14th time they've put on deodorant today.
How many times did you put on deodorant? I don't want to know. Never mind.
It's not working, so it didn't matter.
I will admit that it was exciting that this whole event challenged me. I knew from going into it as two girls, the major element that would set us apart was strength. I pre-planned for this, hitting the gym, focusing on heavy weights, and I feel it paid off. Who knew we would have to hike up a mountain and around an obstacle course with a canoe, get the spare tire in and out countless times, pull winch line, and with 25 plus missions, this one right here ranks as the coolest and most stressful of them all. We built a bridge. But then I had to trust that bridge and drive over it with the Jeep. Great news, the bridge held.
The most fun portion of it for me was the canoeing and the high lift jack challenge that was one challenge included. We had to canoe to our waypoint, we had to unload our boat, we had to get the high lift jack out of it, we had to bring our tools with us that we disassembled the high lift jack, we had to pass our pieces through a rope net, we had to climb ourselves over the rope net, then we had to get back down, we had to reassemble our high lift jack, we had to reload it into our canoe and head back to the beginning point. We didn't capsize, which means we still have our high lift jack and it still works. We ate peanut butter and jelly sandwiches pretty much all the time. We would snack a lot, but that's because we didn't have time to eat full meals. We had two full meals essentially while we were there, and they were both scheduled and provided by them, which was actually really good food. Or maybe we were just really, really hungry. We came prepared to be able to make our own food, which we didn't have time, so instead of, you know, throwing it out or trying to take it home, we donated it to some of the volunteers. And one of them actually sent us a picture of the food that we had given her, and she prepared it with her dinner last night.
Nice job. You're good. Doesn't want to tell you when to stop.
How's that?
Good job. Good job.
One of the other things that I can think of that was really important to our world was the fast pace, was the go, go, go. There was no timeouts, there was no stopping. It was a military theme, so our commandants expected us to participate in roll calls, and we had to be in uniform, which was our boots, our pants, our t-shirts, and our caps. So that was another interesting piece to it for us. Because Charlene and I, neither one have ever been in the military. So when they're telling us to do things and they're using those terms, we would kind of have to look around and see what everybody else is doing because we didn't know what they were asking for. Super great guy, like super nice guy. But they totally played the part, they kept the character, they kept the environment right. It was really cool. But that was another piece to our environment was, it was a little bit like a boot camp.
Why are you talking? Get in line, get in line. Get in line!
The camaraderie of the group really was great. If we saw each other at a mission, we would cheer each other on. Passing in canoes, we'd have fun conversation. And the one night a couple of rigs needed help, everyone grouped up to get the work done. On Saturday night, we splurged to wash our hair, but then we were sent out on a night mission that was pretty hysterical. I expand all the week's stories on our website at ladiesoffroadnetwork.com.
All right, good night. Good night. We'll see you tomorrow at the final assault. We got this, girl. 3.5 hours. We're gonna kill it. It's gonna go by really fast, but we're gonna get it done.
100%. Whole time.
Every second.
The most challenging piece for me was insecurities. I had to convince myself, like I said in the beginning, that Charlene had chosen the right person. Then I had to convince myself, even though I knew I could do these things, that I could do them in such a high pressure environment. It was really hard for me mentally to stay focused. I let myself get frustrated a few times and I had to shift gears back. I had to push past it and I had to keep moving. Every time I would get frustrated, I would cost us time and time was costing us points and we were getting every last point we could get. We're getting ready to go get lined up, get where we're going and go get oriented.
You really got this wording down.
I'm getting there.
We have go and then easy. So go is you're good.
Yeah.
Easy's easy.
Yeah, like easy go is that green patch right there.
Good.
And you're gonna be what?
Loud, stern, and confident.
Awesome. I love it.
Got it.
We got this.
We got it.
All right, let's pull up.
Oh my God.
Are we ready?
Charlotte! I had a lot of challenges missing my son. There was a night that I didn't get to talk to him. There's a day that I only touched base home once, and that was really hard for me. But I pushed through it. I didn't let it get me down. I knew that if I could get myself through the next day, that I would make time to call home and get to talk to him. So that was really challenging for me. And the same day that I was dealing with that, my body was not happy with me. I was tired. I was dehydrated. I couldn't hydrate enough. I was drinking, but I couldn't retain it. The heat got to me and I was sweating a lot. So I needed to figure out what I needed to do for myself to make sure that I could retain that water. That was really a challenge for me to figure out what I needed to do to keep my body going so I could keep my brain going. So that physical part of it, I just had to push myself. I had to keep going. I had to remind myself that nobody dies from pain. And I had to just pay attention to what my body was telling me, but I also had to keep reminding myself that I had more in me than what I was putting out.
Kristen did an amazing job. Really, she killed it. There was absolutely nothing that was easy about this event. We found our communication, we looked out for each other. She overcame. We slept in a tent, soaking wet with humidity. We'd never canoed before and didn't capsize. We were both pretty much bruised all over, and all without complaint. The ladies' co-driver challenge worked. Kristen was the perfect match for me at this event. I'm so proud of her. They told us what the final event would be. We had to take our canoe around the obstacle course. Are you kidding me right now? I literally did not know how we were going to do it. I was exhausted and all the weight was going to be on my shoulders. I walked away from the group because I had to visualize what we need to do. Then I pulled Kristen over and gave her the plan. I sat her in the Jeep in the AC so she could run the plan over and over in her head. And I stood outside the Jeep and stretched a lot. I was nervous, and of course, failure was not an option. But guess what? Of course, we did it. I put the canoe on my back, she led the helm, and we made it. We tried, and we finished.
Three takeaways for me are don't let my frustration slow me down. Get frustrated, quickly push it aside, and keep moving. Another one for me is just to stay focused. Not backtracking, not tripping over my own thoughts, and just stay focused. And the last one would be a positive attitude changes everything. This weekend would have been completely different if we had let our frustrations and we had let the heat and we had let the environment get to us. Keeping a positive attitude totally changed the whole event for us, and it changed the event for a lot of people around us. And a positive attitude is contagious, so that's a huge takeaway for me.
Kristen and I took second in the pro class behind Casey Curry in Oregon. Congratulations also goes out to Les Clippard and William White for their amateur win.
Our three sponsored teams really put a lot into this, and coming here was a stretch. Some of these people traveled from how far away? Southern California. That's a haul, 28 miles. More like 2,000 when I look at the map. Y'all came a long way, a lot went into this, and I know there was a selection process, Kristen, for you to be the co-driver and actually join this challenge. The Tread Lightly team, you guys have been awesome. It's been a great weekend. I'd like a round of applause for our sponsor team.
Thank everybody. Everybody. I'm not going to take the time to just go through all the names, but you know who you are. So thank you so much for what everybody's done, and love every one of you. Really do. God bless.
We love you, Scott.
Thank you, Scott.
When this idea came to us from Richard, I never imagined it would end up to be this. And it was a lot of hard work, but seeing you guys sitting here in front of us, seeing you guys go through those competitions, seeing the smiles, the enjoyment, watching you guys have to come take a selfie with me. That talked to me and didn't realize it was me and didn't get the selfie, I'm sorry. But just seeing that much fun, guys, that made it worthwhile for us. It really does. I'm glad you guys enjoyed the event. I hope to see you guys again in the future at the next event. We're going to do this again next year.
Not in August.
No. We'll see. We'll see about the date.
Winter time.
Perfect weather.
So thank you guys for coming out. Thank you again for putting your faith in us. Sponsor team, thank you guys for coming out. Charlene, massive amount of heart. Thank you, Aton.
Thank you.
Casey, thanks for coming out, showing us the cool rig, right, out here on the East Coast. We don't get to see those 39s every day. That's pretty cool. Tread Lightly team, man, thanks for coming out and doing what you guys did, being a part of that. All right.
We wrapped up the event, said goodbye to all of our new friends, and actually walked into an Outback Steakhouse still filthy dirty. We were hungry, and we deserved the steak.
We are going to be at our hotel in 2 minutes.
Oh my God, this is so exciting.
we get to take a shower, we get to put on clean clothes, we get to lay down in a bed with dry pillows.
Our last job was to drop all my gear at Casey Curry's semi that I would see in SoCal 33 days later, and off to the airport for some emotional goodbyes.
I think the Ladies Co-Driver Challenge was one of the best things that I have ever done. I've learned a lot about myself in the last few months. I've learned a lot about the people around me, and I was able to step outside of the box, put myself outside of my comfort zone, and that's where things happen. It was kind of one of those things in the beginning that I was going to put myself out there and I was just going to wait and see what happened. As my piece of it gained momentum, I was able to push myself and I was able to focus on the people around me cheering me on. And I really think it's one of the best things I could have done for myself. So I encourage anybody who's watching this, ladies, get out there and enter. Do it. Put yourself out there. See what you can get out of it. Guys, encourage your ladies to do this. Moms and dads, encourage your daughters to do this. Even if it's not the co-driver challenge, encourage them to step outside of the box. Encourage them to challenge themselves. Encourage them to stand a little taller. I think it's important. I think it's hugely important, and the co-driver challenge taught me that. I just want to say thank you to everyone involved, to my support system, to my family, to all of my friends. I want to say thank you to Charlene for giving me this opportunity, BF Goodrich Tires for making it happen, Warren, Highlift Jack, Jeep, everybody who was involved in this, from the top to the bottom, all the volunteers for the events, Charlene's mom for helping us in Arizona, everybody who was involved. If I don't name you and you feel like you were involved, then you have my appreciation. I just want to say thank you to everybody. I love you guys, and I will not be the same person that I was yesterday.
We just finished the BF Goodrich Tires 36 Hours of Uwharrie. I am so proud of Kristen and all the effort that she put into it. It was tough. It was challenging. I had so many firsts, as you guys have just heard about. It's so exciting. And now we're gonna go home. We're gonna talk to our family. We're gonna talk to our friends. We're gonna try and tell all these stories. And you know what? They're not even gonna be close to the magnitude of what we just went through. It was insane. And I hope everybody thinks about joining in next year to be part of 36 Hours Uwharrie. Anyways, as far as the Ladies Co-Driver Challenge goes, that was event number 2. And even next weekend, I'm starting to train for the Rebel Rally, which is event number 3 with Kylie. And again, 2017, man, do we have plans for you. Ladies, get ready.
Thank you, BFG!
Party.
I'm too tired.
Oh, come on, let's party.